Good morning, students. Today we will discuss on the next part of this topic, alkynes. Now, first introduction. Alkynes are aliphatic unsaturated hydrocarbons. Alkynes are unsaturated hydrocarbons. They contain one carbon-carbon triple bond. They contain one carbon-carbon triple bond, and they have the general formula CnH2n-2. This is the introduction. Alkynes are aliphatic unsaturated hydrocarbons. Unsaturated hydrocarbons. They contain one carbon-carbon triple bond, and they have the general formula CnH2n-2. This is the introduction. Now, the next part is the preparation of ethyne. From calcium carbide on hydrolysis, it gives the ethyne. The common name of ethyne is acetylene. Now, when this calcium carbide hydrolyzed with water, it gives acetylene. Now, these two carbonyl and these two H combined, two carbonyl and two H. So these two carbon and these two H to form the ethyne, it is commonly called acetylene. Then this remaining is Ca and this toil OH, calcium hydroxide. So this is the first method for the preparation of ethyne, that is the hydrolysis of calcium carbide. Now the second method, from iodoform, from the iodoform. Now when iodoform reacts with silver powder, it gives the ethyne. Now these are the two molecules of iodoform, CHI3 iodoform. One reacts with the silver powder. Now this is the silver powder. Now this six ion, this six AG, it gives the six AG. The remaining this CH and this CH, the CH triple bond CH, this ethyne is formed. So the second way is from the iodoform. When two molecules of iodoform react with silver powder, it gives the ethyne or acetylene. So this is the second method for preparation. So the next part is the chemical reaction. First chemical reaction is the electrophilic addition of HBr. Now this is the electrophilic addition of HBr to ethyne. Where this ethyne reacts with HBr to give the first vinyl bromide. When ethyne reacts with HBr, it gives first vinyl bromide. From this HBr, this H will be linked with any CH. If this H is linked with this CH and this Br is linked with this CH to get CH2 double bond CHBr. So this is the first step, formation of vinyl bromide. Vinyl bromide again reacts with the second molecule of HBr. Now in this step, the addition of HBr takes place according to the Marconi process. Now what is the Marconi process? The negative part of this reagent is added to that carbon atom which having the less number of hydrogen atoms. So this Br is added to this carbon, double bonded carbon, which having the less number of hydrogens, and therefore this H plus is added to this carbon. So we will get that this CH is going to be CH3. Now this CH and one more Br to form the CH3CHBr. So that is the formation of 1,1-dibromoethane. So this is the chemical reaction, first electrophilic addition of HBr. So there are just two steps of the reactions. First, ethyne reacts with HBr to form the vinyl bromide, and when vinyl bromide reacts with second molecule of HBr, the addition of HBr takes place according to Marconi process and to get the 1,1-dibromoethane. Now the mechanism of this reaction. Mechanism, step first. Formation of an electrophile. The first step is the formation of an electrophile. Now dissociation of H pair to form the electrophile H plus. Now this H pair dissociate to form the H plus I Br minus. So this bond is formed from this Br to form the H plus I Br. Now the second set electrophile, that is the H plus electrophile H plus I to ethyne to form the carbocation. Now this H plus I, this H plus I combined with this CH. First, this bond is formed from this carbon becomes negatively charged, and this negatively charged carbon combined with H plus I to form the carbocation. This carbon carries positive charge, therefore to form the carbocation. Now step for carbocation combined with Br minus, that is the bromide ion, to form the vinyl bromide. So this positively charged carbon combined with this Br minus to form the vinyl bromide. Now the step fourth is the vinyl bromide combined with HBr. That is the vinyl bromide combined with second molecule of HBr to form the 1,1 dibromo ethane. Now in this phase, the addition of HBr takes place according to Markov process, and that is the negative part of this reagent is added to that carbon which has the less number of hydrogen atoms. The negative part of carbon, this reagent is added to that carbon which has the less number of hydrogen, and this positive part is added to that carbon which has the large number of hydrogen. Now this Br is added to this carbon atom, so this is the Br. On this H plus combined with this CH2, it becomes CH3. So CH3CH Br2. So it is a 1,1 dibromo ethane. So this is the formation of 1,1 dibromo ethane. So this is the first chemical reaction, that is the addition of HBr, the total addition of HBr to ethyne. The next reaction is the total addition of Br to ethyne. Now this ethyne combined with this liquid bromine to form first 1,2 dibromo ethene. Now this 1,2 dibromo ethene again combines second molecule of Br2 to form the 1,1,2,2 tetrabromo ethene. So next product of this reaction is the 1,1,2,2 tetrabromo ethene. That is, when ethyne combines 2 molecule of bromine, we will get 1,1,2,2 tetrabromo ethene. So now mechanism of this reaction, first step, the formation of an electrophile, that is the Br plus bromonium ion. This bromine dissociates to form the bromonium ion Br plus and bromide minus ion. So this Br to dissociate, we will get this Br plus plus and Br minus. Now second thing is, this electrophile Br plus combined with ethyne to form the carbocation. Now this bond is transformed this carbon atom, this carbon becomes negatively charged and this carbon becomes positive. Negatively charged carbon combined with this Br plus to form the this carbocation. So this is the second step. Now first step, carbocation combined with this bromide ion, that is the Br minus ion, to form the 1,2 dibromo ethane. So this positively charged carbon combined with this Br minus to form the 1,2 dibromo ethene. To form the 1,2 dibromo ethene. And then for last and fourth step, this 1,2 dibromo ethene combined with the second molecule of Br2. It is combined with the second molecule of Br2 to form the 1,1,2,2 tetrabromo ethene. Now the addition of this Br added to this carbon and this Br added to this carbon. So we will get the 1,1,2,2 tetrabromo ethene. So this is the net product of this reaction, that is the electrophilic addition of Br2 to ethyne. So these are the two chemical reactions of alkynes. Now today we have completed the topic alkenes, alkenes and alkynes.